Quick Target's beam settings is where you can create target positions for things like bounce mirrors, mirror balls, or just exact positions. This is often easier, safer, and more reliable than using shapes or synth images to create these targets, and in a moment we'll see why. Quick Targets also have great DMX capabilities to control your targets like lighting fixtures. First, let's create new zones to be used exclusively for your targets. This will help keep you safe, and if you need to change positions of zones, it makes it easier and quickly to change your programming. Once you have the zones made for your areas, and we have zoned them around whatever objects you would like to target, we can go to the Quick Targets Beam Settings window. Go to Settings, Quick Targets Beam Settings. This will open the window where you can create and set up targets. On the top of this window, you have your standard, new, open, and save. All of your settings in this window can be saved to a file to be recalled later. To the right of that, we have a few options for how this window can display data. The first numbers of your beams is easier to keep track. Next, we'll show the color of the beam if it's set. And third shows your zones of which the points are bound to. And you can also draw a line to the points from the zones with this button. The last important one is the button which allows you to set the number of beams you have in your quick targets. You can go from 32 all the way to 1024 points. Below all these buttons is your main preview window. This shows a layer of all your zones and the beam positions inside of those zones. This is also where you make position adjustments to your beams. To the right is your beam list. This is where you can select, enable, and output each one of your target beams. Let's set one up. We will select beam 1, enable it, and click the check mark to output. Note, until we set a zone and bring the relative power down to 10, we probably shouldn't click show it now to see the lasers for safety reasons. So we'll decide a zone, one of our target zones we created before, and take the relative power down to 10. Now we can click show it now and we'll see it in real life. The most basic type of target is the static beam. If you have the kinetic tracking plugin, you will see a path and XY options, but we cover that in our kinetic tracking video. Static is simply a static beam, so let's go into our preview window and drag our beam into a position we like. This would be on your mirrors, mirror balls, or whatever else you would like to target. You can also move the beam using the arrow keys for more precise movements, holding Control to be even higher resolution, and Shift to have the highest resolution. Once your beam is in the right position, we can determine how it is controlled. Beam sequence is the simplest way. This uses the Quick Targets tab at the bottom of your workspace to create target chases and queues. Own color you can use if you want to determine its color here and control it with the Quick Targets tab, or DMX in, which you can use to control its RGB values and even enable a brightness channel, all being able to be controlled from a lighting console. This means while DMX is active in your workspace, these beams will be controlled by DMX. If intensity is all the way down or your color channels are at zero, the beam will not be scanned. If they're anything above zero, they'll start to scan and follow the DMX. You can set the DMX addresses for RGB and intensity in these fields. We can also fix your beam if it has any scanning artifacts like tails by adding start or end anchors here. Default 3x3 usually works well, but every scanner pair is different. Last, we have the custom image. This allows you to turn your beam into whatever shape you want by either opening a previously drawn frame or adding and creating frames, shapes, abstracts, and more. And if it is more than just a beam, you can set its overall size here to make sure the shape fits on whatever object you're targeting. Now that we have set this up, we can press OK and take a look at the Quick Targets tab. Go to the Quick Targets tab here, we can start creating chases. It will list all the beams that we enabled in the settings windows here, and we can select them to turn them on in that chase step. If you want, you can decide the color at the bottom here and toggle which beams are on for that step. To create a single queue which turns on a single or multiple beams, just have one step and select which beams. Then click down on this preview window and drag it to an empty cell of your workspace. As for chases, you can add steps here and chase multiple beams by either beats or by time using these options. You can play and preview your chase here, and use show it now to preview in real life. Under menu, you can start over, save to queues, load from queues, copy and paste sequences. Thank you for watching our video on Quick Targets beam settings. If you still have questions, you can email our support team at support@pangolin.com and we'll help you as soon as possible. And if you're interested in seeing how cool this feature can be, check out our videos on our kinetic tracking plugin, which uses more options in the Quick Targets beam settings window.